unless specifically not excluded, the concerned tables will apply to companies. Otherwise, I mean, in your articles, you need to specifically mention particular table is not applicable, particularly with relating to any of the provisions that has been mentioned in the articles, only these articles will prevail. So if you have to specifically mention to the last slide, okay, fine. Incorporation, another one, similar procedures, I mean, while doing incorporation, whatever documents you are giving, almost similar, whatever documents you have been giving for incorporation is going to be similar, except that earlier you used to give a declaration from subscribers or the directors. Now they are asking for a affidavit from the subscribers and the first directors, that the directors are not convicted for any offense for promotion of the company. They have not been found guilty for fraud and other offenses during last 5 years. So during last 5 years, they have not been held guilty and information filed by them are correct. So this affidavit has to be filed. Now it is an affidavit. Please next. Okay. Another detail is here, address for correspondence for the company needs to be given. See, earlier Companies Act 1956, at the time of incorporation itself, you need to mention a place as your registered office address. And in many cases, professionals, if it is a practicing company secretary, he will give his office address, or if it is a chartered accountant, he will give his office address as a registered office address of the particular company. And there are instances where they have not filed Form 18 for change of address for registered office, and in case of offenses, notices have gone to the particular practicing company secretary and particular chartered accountants also. Whereas now, law tries to address this issue. It says, at the time of incorporation, you only give address for correspondence. After incorporation, we can file the registered office address. Of course, you have to give proof of identity of subscribers, directors, particulars of firms in which he is a director, and incorporation documents need to be maintained in the ROC office till the dissolution of the company. So incorporation documents are considered as very, very important and need to be kept till the time of dissolution of the company. Deliberate or false information being given, liable for fraud under class 447. I think some other speakers would have also mentioned about fraud. Section 447, normally we used to say 420 for fraud. Here 447. Under Companies Bill, it is 447 for fraud. Please read that clause. They are saying punishment for fraud. Fraud has also been defined. So stringent punishment for giving false information. NCLT can order monetary punishment and imprisonment. It can also pass orders for change in management, and it can direct the liability of members to be unlimited, and it can remove the company from its register. So very, very high penalty has been given for giving incorrect information at the time of incorporation. For all other offenses, the penalty level has been increased to 5 times or 10 times. Here they have given maximum penalty, remove the name of the company from register and all. Next. As I was mentioning, company for charitable objects, earlier we used to say section 25 company, now it is section 8 company. Even a section 8 company can be formed as a one person company, and a firm can be a member of OPC, and similar to the earlier one, it can be amalgamated with another company having similar objects. Next. Okay. These are all similar clauses. Earlier also it is there, because charitable objects, that kind of license is being given on a very, very specific cases by the ROC, and if it is proved that this particular company is not doing for profitable objects or they are doing in certain illegal activities or something, they can at any point of time revoke the license being given. It can order for winding up, and any amount they can transfer to rehabilitation and insolvency fund. There are few funds that have been created in the new company's bill, one such fund is rehabilitation and insolvency fund. Similarly, if the affairs are conducted fraudulently, minimum fine of 10 lakhs and maximum of 1 crore and imprisonment of 3 years can be given in case of a section 8 company. Even for me, it's immediately coming as section 25 company. Yes. Another change is activities like sports, research, protection of environment can be added in the objects of the company. Earlier, that can be there in other objects or incidental objects only. In a company, in a country like us, where we definitely need to encourage sports activities, particularly other than cricket, definitely this would be a welcome step to form charitable company for sports purpose, for encouraging young sportsmen. So now one more change with relating to Section 8 company is for both Memorandum of Association and Articles of Association alteration, it can be done only with the previous approval of central government. Earlier, Memorandum of Association, in specific objects clause amendment, you need to have the central government approval. Now, whether you are, alter your memorandum, any class of your memorandum or articles, central government approval is required, NCLT. Yes. Certificate of commencement of business. One interesting aspect is they have not mentioned anywhere that ROC will give certificate of commencement of business. Earlier, we used to have certificate of incorporation, certificate of commencement of business. My understanding is there is going to be no more certificate of commencement of business, but whatever declarations you file, that is being given on the part of the company, they need to file these declarations. Every company, and see here, public, private or OPC. Earlier, certificate of commencement of business is only for public limited company. Now they are saying every company, public, private or OPC, the director needs to file the following documents with ROC that subscribers have paid their share value and company has filed with ROC the registered office address. As I already mentioned, when the company is being incorporated, they will only give address for correspondence. After incorporation, within 15 days, they need to file the respective form, earlier form 18, registered office address, that it has been filed. If they don't do, penalty of 5,000 rupees and 1,000 rupees per day. The words used here is shall, they shall be punishable. If declaration is not filed within 180 days, ROC may take action for removal of company name. If these declarations have not been filed, ROC has power to even remove the company from the register. Registered office, I was mentioning you, within 15 days of incorporation, a company should have its own registered office. Earlier from the day it is incorporated, company to give registered office address to the ROC within 30 days. So from incorporation, within 15 days, you need to have your registered office, and then within 30 days, you need to file the form address of your registered office. And company name to be painted outside registered office and also in common seal, so which is there in already in the bill, 1956 law. Next. Okay, see, every company is required to print in all business letters, bill heads, etc. the following: telephone number, email ID, website address, fine. In all our letterheads and other things we will mention. The addition is company in SIN number. SIN number of the company needs to be, every company including public or private limited company, their SIN number needs to be mentioned in its letterhead. All communications you are making, all invoices you are sending, SIN number needs to be mentioned. Just very, very, I am only saying these are the changes we need to be careful. We need to advise our own management, our own admin team. This has to change, but not now. Once the when it becomes effective, but probably we can prepare to our own management, to our own clients. These are all the changes applicable to you. It may be applicable from the date it becomes a law. Okay. In case of change of name, again it's saying company needs to mention the old name for 2 years in all its correspondence. Again, bill, whatever communications you are sending, for 2 years within bracket you need to mention previously known as so and so company. And it also says OPC company has to end with the name one person company. It has to end with the OPC to identify that it is a OPC company. Okay, alteration of memorandum of association, similar to earlier ones, special resolution, central government approval. only change is no approval is required for deletion of the word private. No approval. So public to if private to public, a private limited company deletes the word private and becomes a public limited company, no approval is required. Similarly, private limited company deletes the word private, becomes a OPC company, I believe central government approval is not required, because here they are saying no approval is required for deletion of the word private. Okay, public issue through prospectus. A company has issued a public issue and it has issued a prospectus. If still company has some money left, and it shall not alter the objects unless they are giving three conditions. Special resolution is passed. Of course, any object class amendment, special resolution will be passed. Details of resolution should be published in newspaper. Yes, it is also there. The third one is a very, very new concept. They are saying dissenting shareholders must be given an opportunity to exit the company. See, let us visualize the scenario. A company has come out with a public issue saying, I am raising this money for utilizing for this purpose and this purpose. These are all the objects being given. I am raising money for these purposes. But instead of using for that objects, now they are changing the objects. So an investor had invested money for certain reasons. These are the objects for which he is investing. Now they are changing the objects. So then they are saying, that's why they are saying, if any money is left in with them from the money that is being issued through public issue, if any money is still pending, they cannot amend the object clause without giving an opportunity to the shareholders to exit. Either the promoters can buy or directors can buy. An exit mechanism must be provided. Very interesting new concept. Okay, change of registered office from one state to another. Earlier central government approval, now NCLT approval, and new certificate of incorporation will be issued. I believe earlier it is not there. Practicing CS may correct me if I am wrong. That is change of registered office from one state to another state. When you change, new certificate of incorporation will be given. Then application to be disposed of by the ROC or NCLT within 60 days. Time limit has been given. Next. Okay. This is what I was mentioning. Private to public, special resolution only, no central government approval. Public to private, central special resolution as well as NCLT approval is required. Alteration of articles shall be filed with ROC within 15 days. See, normally our mindset is most of the resolutions or most of the forms we need to file within 30 days. In some of the places, we are seeing 15 days time limit. For certain places, they are saying these resolutions should be filed within 15 days. I think the practicing CS need to be careful because they are filing for various clients and penalty will come for late filing. Next. Okay, rectification of name. Registered with identical name. A company has been registered with an identical name of already existing company. Similar provision, already exactly similar provisions are there. ROC may direct the company to change its name and company is required to change its name within 3 months. If its name is identical to a name of a company already registered. The next one is also same, only thing the time limit has been slightly changed. A registered trademark owner, if a registered trademark owner, for example, for some reason or other, I register a company with the name Nirma and that too in the soap powder segment, they can apply to ROC. We are already having this registered trademark with us and this company cannot be incorporated. So earlier they have given 5 years, now they have reduced it to 3 years. That is for any registered trademark owner to object that a company has been incorporated with a similar name. So that period has been reduced to 3 years now. Next. Okay, copy of memorandum and articles needs to be given to shareholders. You would have already studied. And only thing is fee to be charged by them to the shareholders. See, particularly when you are in a listed company, you will face this kind of nuisance shareholders. They will always write, give me a copy of this, give me a copy of that. Particularly, there are, I can even mention that name, Anil Podar. This name is quite, everybody, I think so many people are laughing. Every year he will send I want details of investment, register of directors, register of shareholding, register. So all this, every year he will send. I humbly request you, I have so many things he will mention. So since we listed company secretaries, we talked to them, what kind of reply you give. Now we have formed the standard reply. You send 1,000 rupees for all this. After that, we will return. When we send that reply, he will not reply. So that is the standard reply we give, and many of my friends also give. I mean, the advice has been given by a senior company secretary. So this kind of nuisance creating people are also there. So they are only saying for giving copy of that memorandum and articles, fee to be charged, and the fee will be prescribed. Next. Conversion of company. Very, very important, because now there are few more kinds of companies going to come. Small company is coming, one person company is coming. So conversion of companies definitely are going to happen. This is the class which provides for the conversion. It says a company of any class may convert itself into a